The COVID story in Goa, which continues to remain a huge cause of concern. According to a tweet by the former Deputy Chief Minister of Goa, Vijay Sardesai, another 13 patients have died at the Goa Medical College Hospital. There have been a string of COVID deaths allegedly caused not due to COVID-19, but due to logistical issues regarding the shortage of supply of medical oxygen in Goa's premier hospital. The Bombay High Court Goa bench has also told the state government to ensure that there would be no more deaths in the state due to a shortage of medical oxygen.
Totally 75 people have died at the dark hour, which is the time from 1 a.m. to 6 a.m. in the dead of the night, on last four consecutive nights. On the 10th night, it was 26 people. On the 11th night, it was 21 people. On the 12th night, it was 15 people. And now, last night, it was 13 people. So 75 people have died on four consecutive nights because of oxygen shortage. Basically, mismanagement of oxygen supply in the Goa Medical College, which is the premier hospital in Goa. Now, there is a complete collapse of governance in Goa. The High Court has invoked the Article 21 of the Constitution, which is right to life. In spite of the High Court intervention, the deaths are happening at this dark hour, and that is why people believe now that more than the government, it should be the High Court that should rule Goa, because the government is doing nothing other than photo ops and filing cases against those who expose them.
And we spoke earlier to a resident of Goa, Ashley Delaney, who was admitted to the Goa Medical College Hospital and also has a relative admitted in the same hospital. Here's what he told us.
Okay, so for the first couple of nights, we didn't really pay attention to it. But after three, four nights, it became a regular feature. That's when I noticed and I kept a track of the time, because we realized that, you know, the patient, my relative's condition was deteriorating only at night. And that's when we started questioning and realizing that the oxygen levels were actually dipping. So initially it was just a couple of people that, you know, were getting affected. But then one fine day, one entire ward ran out of oxygen, and I couldn't take it anymore, because it was no longer just my relative. It was a question of 25 people in that ward. And that's when we appealed for help and asked people, and it became really a known feature then. It took us nearly around about 5 hours to get it done. I know there are a lot of deaths because we're actually seeing it at night, and suddenly the drop is there because there's a lot of oxygen. The ventilators start beeping. There's a red light flashing, so it shows there's a lack of oxygen intake that's coming into the system. So we know immediately that there's a drop at that point of time, and then we rush to connect the patients that are there onto cylinders instead of the central line. And if there's a lack of cylinders, which there always is,